Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1523, Comparative Histogram 2. Oh, hey, in yesterday's podcast, episode 1522, JB had asked how to create a comparative histogram. I showed how to do it with a chart, but you know, there's a couple of other tools. Let's just go incredibly old school here. Equal REPT, the repeat function, repeats text a given number of times. I want to repeat the vertical bar character, and we will say that I want to repeat it, let's say 90 divided by 3. You kind of have to scale this. Like if I had 90 vertical bars, it would be really wide, wouldn't fit on a piece of paper. So divided by 3, and you see, you kind of get that same effect. All right, now let's copy it over here for the males. To make this look better, though, we'll take the change the font for the males to red. We'll also go right justified for the males. Should have done that there. I'll press F4 to repeat. And then here we will change the color. So home and use one of the blues. All right, so you kind of get that comparative histogram look. Certainly not as fancy as the chart, but we get the labels where we want them, and that would work. If you happen to be in Excel 2010, then you could use this method. Now we'll take the females, home, styles, conditional formatting, data bars, and I'm going to choose the solid blue data bar for females, and over here, home, conditional formatting, data bars, I'll choose the solid red for the males. Okay, now you could have done this in Excel 2007. It's this next step that only became available starting in Excel 2010. I'm going to come down here to manage rules, and I'm going to edit that rule, and they've added a great setting of bar direction, and I can say that I want it to go right to left, show bar only. Click OK, and then we'll come over here and manage rules again, edit, and show bar only. That time I'll let it go left to right. Click OK, So there you have a comparative histogram, Excel 2010 only or newer, using the conditional formatting data bars. For more great ideas about charts and graphs and data visualization, check out my book, Charts and Graphs, Microsoft Excel 2010 from the Mr. Excel Library. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.